Alzheimer's impacts half of all Black families. HSC is investing in a new research study to find out why. To join, please visit blackalzbrainstudy.com or call 817-735-2963. It's Sybil Wilkes with what you need to know. Today is Tuesday, March 30th, 2021. Number one, opening statements began Monday morning in the trial of Derek Chauvin, the white former Minneapolis police officer charged in the death of George Floyd. The first witness, a 911 dispatcher, said a gut reaction of watching the live stream that something's not going right prompted her to call a supervisor. While watching the incident, the dispatcher said the restraint happened for so long, she initially thought the cameras were frozen. Number two, the state's attorney for the city of Baltimore, Marilyn Mosby, has announced she will no longer prosecute drug possession, prostitution, low-level crimes, and minor traffic violations. Mosby stopped prosecuting these types of crimes 1 year ago in order to curb the spread of COVID-19 in jails. This change will continue to bring a drastic shift in how the Baltimore Police Department will do its job in the future, as officers and prosecutors will focus on violent crime and drug trafficking. Number three, several states are reporting an increase in COVID-19 infections, and some state leaders are sounding the alarm. According to data from Johns Hopkins University, more than two dozen states are reporting at least a 10% increase in new infections compared to the previous week. Some state health officials say many of the new infections appear to be among younger groups. Number four, conflicting reports were released over the weekend concerning the fatal shooting of 25-year-old Donovan Lynch, the African-American college graduate, business owner, and former college athlete. He was shot and killed by police Friday night during one of three separate shootings that took place at the Virginia Beach oceanfront. The Virginia Beach Police Department and the Commonwealth's Attorney's Office are treating this as a criminal investigation. Number five, most Black parents begin saving for college before their child is 10 years old. And this could be a future key to closing the racial wealth gap. Only 16% of African-American parents are saving for college using a 529 plan, which is like a prepaid tuition program. Despite the benefits of saving for college with a 529 plan, 45% of parents say they continue to keep their college savings in a general bank account. Here's your daily inspiration from Yogi's Jewels. Do the right thing, even when no one else is looking. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with J. Anthony Brown as we discuss today's top headlines and more. Thank you to our What You Need to Know partners, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Black Voters Matter, and the University of North Texas Health Science Center at Fort Worth. To subscribe to my free daily newsletter, please visit SybilWilkes.com. Be informed, be empowered.